Star Wars fans, now find out on Next Figure Review. Moving on, still with Entertainment Earth comic packs. We've been looking at some of these new releases that have finally managed to reach us. These packs were announced and released, I think, way back in April of this year, I'm sure it was. But certainly the ones that we're reviewing here today, we're going to do part one of two. So this is a two-part review. And the first figure we're going to give you is Montross, this guy here. Let me just give you the zoom in and you can see the details. Now, if you haven't seen this comic pack here, there, I really urge you to get one. I do have the comic somewhere. I've just misplaced it just now. But the comic itself is called Jango Fett Open Season. It's one of the finest comics I've read in the Star Wars line. At its time, certainly, it was one of the strongest comics that was out in Star Wars. There really have been some much better ones in recent years, but this one was stands a favorite of mine. Great cover art as well, so sorry I don't have that here to show you, but it is a great comic. So Montross is the figure we're going to review. There he is. Let me just take him off his stand. And this is the figure we get. So he's a Mandalorian. Bounty Hunter, there's probably more of the backstory there, but we're interested in the figure for the time being. He is a particularly cool figure. We've got articulation all over and lots of weapons and cool stuff. And if you read the comics, you'll know exactly what I mean. So let's delve in first of all with all the attachments and accoutrements that he comes with, and we'll give you a look at the articulation in detail thereafter. So it's just a quick usual HD scan around to give you a good 360 of the figure and all the other elements that he comes with. Kit bashing bits and pieces from Boba Fett figures and Jango Fett from the past, but it's still a particularly cool figure nonetheless. So, let me take off the backpack, which I'll give you a look at first of all. Standard backpack, I've seen it many times before, and I think Jango Fett. And off it comes, standard kind of placement. The cape has this hole you can see, which fits in just neatly with the hole underneath. And there we go. So just looking at the back of the figure, it has this belt with these tassels hanging down the back, which is kind of cool. And in terms of blasters and weapons, he has this awesome rifle that he has in his hands. They have never seen this before. And I hope we get to see that again. Really love it. The wooden hilt at the end on the handle and on the gold, but I think it looks wooden anyway. Lots of touches on the rifle. It's just really chunky. Fits well in those hands, which the hands seem to be very much larger than previous figures I've seen. As you can see, the fingers right through the trigger, and it's quite comfortable. The hands are a good size on this figure, and they really hold well onto these rather awesome looking blasters. The other one you'll see there, there's two of them. One's in his holster, is this again, this wooden type effect, huge kind of blaster, but again, unique to the figure, very comic book accurate and correct. Some real love from the Hasbro sculptors there, but a really good blaster. So three rifles the guy comes with. Let's just put that in there. And what we've got is Montross removable helmet. So let me just compare on screen. Let's see how he looks. If I can try and get this this right. Does Montross look like Montross? No, I think Montross looks like Montross. So pretty accurate looking guy. And a good job from Hasbro on the facial sculpt. Let me give you just a close up on that a little bit more. Slightly featureless looking face. There's not a great deal to him. Let me just zoom back in a little more. Get a real close up for you. There we go. Is that better? So, again, not a great deal to tell you about that. Looking down the body itself again, great paintwork. The pistol pouches, utility belts, all the touches, even down to the boots, details of color on there. Very, very cool figure. Very, very cool indeed. So there you go. Okay, in terms of articulation, what do we have? Well, we have a movable head, obviously. It's stuck on a ball joint, but it doesn't move too much. In terms of the shoulders, we have a limited, again, articulation because of these shoulder pads here, they only go so far. Full swivel ball joint at the elbows and on the wrists. Oops, let me just take that pistol out. We have movable wrist as well, so you've got plenty of articulation there. On the waist, again, articulated waist. On the hips, they're just swivel hips, so they just move back and forth from the ball joint on them. On the knees, you've got a swivel, a ball jointed knee. And on the ankles, we have awesome ankle articulation. So really all in an awesome looking figure that is a particularly cool one, I think, for me because of the Bounty Hunter and the Mandalore connection. As I said, a great connection. If you've ever played the game Jango Fett Bounty Hunter, pretty much an awful game, but the cutscenes are one of the finest I've ever seen from ILM and tells a fantastic story of Jango Fett that is George Lucas canon and really is a particularly good feature, Zam Wessel and a few other faces. But a great looking figure. So that's part one of two. Stay tuned for Jasta Mareel, who is the other person in this comic pack. And I'll dig out the comic at that point before we do it, so to give you a look at that too. So try and pick this one up. Entertainment Earth, I'll put a link under the video to order it. And get them while they last, because these are particularly cool. See you soon for another review. Cheers.